Happy Monday, my peoples. It's your boy Change Agent Cooper coming to you live from Asheville, North Carolina. Hashtag Appalachia Strong. Hashtag Voices of Afrolatia. Hashtag Inspire or Retire. Let's go! This morning, I want to talk about a controversial topic that I've heard people discussing in the recovery community. There is power in language, and it is just one word that has caused some people to cringe. And I've heard some folks who were like earlier in recovery making statements about this word and how it applies to them. And since I heard these people talking about that, not just people in early recovery, but even old timers, I guess you can call me an old timer now because I've been clean and sober for a nice amount of time now, going on 13 years. Glory be to God. But I wanted to weigh in on how I feel about it, man, because I know I do have some followers and some people that look to me for some wisdom as it pertains to, you know, recovery and everything. So it's only right that I weigh in on this. So the word addict. Some people have said, you know, once an addict, always an addict. Some people be like, you know, I fully recovered, I'm not an addict anymore. And I've heard people say different things as it relates to that word. But I'm going to tell y'all what, I got to weigh in. I got to definitely weigh in. So there's two sides of it. So the one side of it for me, you know, I'm totally fine with saying once an addict, always an addict. But it took me some maturing to get here. And it took me some embracing, you know, understanding the disease portion of this substance use disorder, right? And when I say that I'm an addict, it's not like I don't see that word necessarily as a negative word. You know, it's just me understanding that I can't do just a little bit. I can't do just a little bit. You feel me? I know for a fact that I can't just do a little bit of weed or coke or liquor. You know what I'm saying? The Hen Dog, the Jose Cuervo, none of that. Like, I can't just sniff a line of coke. I can't just smoke a rock. You know, I can't just pop some opioids for and have a great night out at the club. Like, that's not me. I can't do it. I can't do just a little bit. I don't know how to do just a little bit. My body is not wired to do just a little bit. Once I put some in, I go all the way to jail. That's my story, fam. Like, when I use a lot. And I go and I go and I go and I commit crimes because it does something. My mind is not, it doesn't do well. And so when I hear the word addict, or when I say that I'm an addict, why it doesn't bother me to say, you know, my name is Philip and I'm a recovering addict, or my name is Philip and I'm an addict. The reason why I don't feel no type of way about that word, because when I look at it, I see it as the disease part of it that says that Philip can't successfully use any minor mood altering substances. You dig? He can't successfully do it. He can't socially do it. I, Philip Cooper, can't socially do nothing. None of that. I can't just go, y'all want to go see the fight at Wild Wings and have some drinks and stuff like that. I won't be drinking nothing. I am fully convinced that I cannot successfully use, not today. And I practice a daily program, you feel me, one day at a time. But I'm telling y'all, like today, just for today, and it's been a lot of days over and over and over to get to almost 13 years. Can I get an amen? Glory be to God. But what I'm saying is that word don't bother me, because I look at it as that, as the reason why I can't successfully use. And it don't bother me. For some people, when they hear the word, you know, it's like they see it as a negative way. And so this is the other side of it, right? The other side of it is that some people have been called an addict in a derogatory way. You know what I'm saying? And so whenever somebody says the word, they only think of the derogatory aspect of it. And they might only hear that one person's voice who is saying, you ain't nothing but an addict. You're a dirty, filthy addict or whatever. You feel me? And so those people are probably remembering that part of it, you know? And so when they hear somebody say that they're an addict, it might make them cringe. But this is the part of it too. I want to compare it to like the word nigga. You feel me? N-I-G-G-A. So I ain't gonna lie. Sometimes it'll slip out. It's depending if, like, if I'm kicking it with some of the guys. You know what I'm saying? Like, there are times I'm like, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? It might come out still sometimes. But I'm gonna be honest with y'all. Like, I don't want nobody white calling me no nigga. Period. And so how does that relate to the word addict? Well, some people, when they have been called an addict by somebody who is not a person that's in recovery, or a person that's not an addict, then they feel some type of way. And I compare that to when some black guys like myself that's from the hood, you feel me, we call each other nigga, you feel me? And I'm trying not to do that as much because some of my mentors, it bothers them. And different people see the word nigga in different ways. You know, niggas means king, you know what I'm saying? But like that word, there's controversy behind that word as well. So I want to compare that word addict to the word nigga, because like if you're not a black person calling a black person nigga, that ain't it, fam. You know, and there's controversy behind it. Well, why can y'all say it? And why can't we say it? You know, whatever. No, just leave the whole word alone. But this is what I am saying is like for those people who are in recovery from addiction, if a person that's not an addict calls them an addict, they might feel some type of way. And I ain't even gonna lie, I done been in meetings, and I done been not like recovery meetings, but I done been in like some of the meetings that, with the work that I do, because you know there's politics involved and everything like that. And I'm being in meetings, and some of these people, you know, they haven't been trained, they haven't had the stigma slang training, they ain't had the language training and stuff like that. Like, and so they may say like the addicts, those people, you know what I'm saying? They say those people are those addicts, you know, they're addicts, you know, and sometimes when I hear that, it still does catch me off guard, like, ugh, you know, I didn't like how that sounds. So I just wanted to weigh in about it, y'all, because like you might hear people saying different things, but as far as that word, but like for many of us within the recovery community, we don't mind the word addict at all, because we understand like we are addicts because we can't successfully use. And that's the only thing that makes me an addict. And I don't mind saying my name is Philip and I'm a recovering addict, because I need people to know, like, look, if you want to know my story, you dig, I can tell you my story. And when you hear my story and you see where I'm at today, then you're going to know that there's hope. And there might be somebody in your family that need to hear that story. There may be somebody that's at your job that need to hear that story. There may be your baby daddy might need to hear that story. You feel me? To know that people do recover. People who was even like super, super gone. You feel me? Because I was gone. I ain't going to lie, y'all. I was lost in the sauce. You know, I was knee deep in the streets and I was staying high as a kite. I was using the hard stuff. You feel me? I wasn't making no money no more. I was just hiding out in motel rooms with guns. You know what I'm saying? And staying high because I couldn't face my feelings. And see, that's the other part of it too, like being an addict, I understand like it's a spiritual solution that comes for it, you feel me? Because most people who become addicts, they get to that point because they start to utilize the drugs. Because I'm just say I, let me use I statements, because you can hear somebody else's story. I ain't gonna tell you their story, they can tell you their story. But I started using drugs, and I kept using drugs because I didn't want to face life on life's terms, those negative feelings, those emotions. I didn't know how to experience my emotions, and that's what made me continue to use. And people think that like, you just using because you want to use. No, it stopped being fun at one point. At one point it stopped being fun. And when it was no longer fun, I still had to use because I didn't know how to face life. Yeah, that part. And that's what makes me an addict. And I don't mind being called an addict. But be ye steadfast and stay woke, because some people do mind that. You feel me? That might hurt some feelings. So just be careful with the language and everything. You know, there are different pathways of recovery. You know, I chose the abstinence-based pathway. You know, I love me some meetings in the basement of churches. I don't need to promote those because it violates traditions. I will say I'm an active member of Celebrate Recovery. It's a little different in there. We do talk super Jesus with the 12 steps. And love it. Love it. Recovery is my jam, man. And I don't see me being an addict as a negative thing either. I see it as something that gave me a superpower. And that's a fact. Like, I really see me being a person in recovery as being it's a superpower. And everything that I experienced while I was using hard drugs, that made me a superhero in this world today. Because there are a lot of people that are struggling with substance use right now. And who do they turn to when it's time to get that sharpening, when it's time to get that hope? They turn to other people who have been successfully in recovery. And that's your evidence. You dig? The therapeutic value of one addict helping another is without parallel. My name is Change Agent Cooper, and I'm not the answer, but I'm for damn sure the alternative. Y'all have a blessed day.